Okay. All right, welcome everyone to the board meeting. Hopefully you can see, if you need to download the agenda, it is on the board page, and we'll kick the meeting off. Pursuant to the New Jersey Open Public Meetings Act, NJSA 10:4-10, adequate notice of this meeting has been provided by advertising such notice in the Home News Tribune, the Asbury Park Press, the board office, the schools, and on Cablevision channel 118, and BIOS channel 24, and by filing such notice with the township clerk. This meeting was scheduled for Tuesday, May 19th, 2020. The board will take formal action on payment of bills and other agenda items. Mr. Mayor, please.
The Old Bridge Township Board of Education acknowledges that the law of this state establishes that members of the public, including members of the board, have the right to record public board meetings using audio or video recording devices, provided that that active recording does not interfere with the business of this public board meeting. Therefore, the board makes it known that any such recording is to be considered the private recording of the individual and in no manner represents the official record of this board. The board therefore takes no responsibility for such private recording and completely disavows any future use.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Burns?
Here.
Callie?
Here.
DeCaro?
Here.
DePrima?
Here.
Dunn?
Here.
Giordano?
Here.
Lent?
Here.
Solikowski? Ellis Foster?
Here.
Quorum exists.
Okay, I do see Mr. Solikowski is online.
You
can see.
He's not muted.
Okay, so we see him. All right, hopefully we'll figure that one out for the next thing.
Okay, now can I just ask, is Mr. Tui here?
Yes, he is.
Ms. Ms. Keeler?
She's here.
Yes. Okay, thank you.
You guys can answer on your own, I guess, okay. All right, thank you, everyone. I'll ask you now to please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I'd like to ask everyone to also please stand for a moment of silence. The board acknowledges the passing of Elena Stiles, substitute teacher, Dorothy Hassentap, retired executive secretary, and Kendall Bresnick, Southwood Elementary student. We express our deepest sympathy to their families and friends. Okay, thank you, everyone. So thank you, everyone who's watching. We'll kick off with our code of ethics corner. And Mrs. Kelly, I believe you said you would take that this time?
Yes.
Is that in my notes? Okay, good.
Thank you. The code of ethics highlight of the month, the board member will carry out his or her responsibility not to administer the schools, but together with fellow board members, ensure they are run well.
Thank you. Our first agenda item is just the approval of minutes. Could I have a motion, please?
I'll move it.
Lent will second.
Thank you. Any questions, comments? Okay, roll call, please, Mr. Mayor. Oh, Mr. Mayor, you're on mute.
Bill, you're muted.
Can I just make one suggestion? When we're taking the motions, if the individuals can say their name, like Lent first or Callie second.
All right.
So Burns?
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Approval of the minutes, resolution one passes.
Thank you. So actually now I would like to, we have to move on to recognition. So it's something good. I'm now going to actually pass it over to Dr. Hoker. Oh, you were muted.
Yes, I'm working on that. Thank you. I just want to congratulate all of the recipients for this evening on our teacher recognition. I think, Ms. Foster, were you going to go right into the video?
Whenever you tell me.
Okay. We do have something in the absence of being here together that we put together to just honor our recipients. So I'm going to ask you to go ahead and play that.
Okay. One sec.
This is one of those things that we tested multiple times, so it'll get there.
Oh, it wasn't sharing. Hang on. Apologies. Is it? Am I showing? Are you seeing the video?
No, just the first page.
Oh, but you were saying okay.
No, that was it. That was it. You just, I think, have to hit the play.
Yep. Hang on.
Try that one more time.
While we're waiting for that, I'll just like to say this student recognition is part of a process that is part of not only the Board of Education, the Old Bridge Education Association, the Old Bridge Administrator Association, the Old Bridge Supervisor Association, and our school PTAs. And we really take pride in having a great ceremony in person. And for obvious reasons, this is our first ceremony that is a virtual ceremony. One I fear of many to come in the next few months. So congratulations to all of those who participated in selecting their peers for Teacher of the Year and Support Personnel of the Year. And congratulations to the winners. And thank you to everyone and all the groups that make it possible to have this process.
Mr. Cittadino, did you want to?
Yes, I spoke earlier. I don't know if anybody heard me. Did you guys not hear me earlier?
It was garbled.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Hear you loud and clear.
So, we have a storied history with this, our presentation of the Teacher of the Year in Old Bridge, and something that we added as a district was the Support Personnel of the Year, and that has certainly grown over the past few years. When we lost support from the state on the Teacher of the Year program. So we're very proud of that, and none of it would be possible first without the peers of those who were selected, because they go through the process of selecting the teachers and the support personnel for everything that they do throughout the course of the year. And then that program is then supported by the OBEA, the Old Bridge Administrators Association, and the Old Bridge Supervisors Association, and then formally supported and supported further by the PTA President's Council and the PTAs from each school. None of that would be possible without this. Now, this was our first kind of virtual moving up ceremony type of ceremony that I'm sure we'll see lots of in the next few months. And I do want to put it out there that in the future, when we can all get together and have a regular meeting, I do want to invite all of the attendees to come back and be recognized, because they do such a great job. So thank you very much. And congratulations to all of those selected.
Great, thank you. And actually during the public comments, I'm gonna also let Mr. O'Neill say a few words. I'm gonna go a little crazy, and I'm gonna actually just unmute and let Mr. O'Neill kind of make his comment right now. So, Mr. O'Neill, because you put in a lengthy chat, so again, you're part of the process. So if you'd like to say a few words.
Sure, can you hear me?
Yep, we can hear you.
Okay, I'm double whammied because I have a power outage at my house right now, so I wasn't sure. On behalf of the OBEA, I'd like to congratulate those being honored as Teacher or ESP of the Year tonight. Although we can't recognize these exceptional educators in every way we would like to right now, the OBEA, OBAA, and OBSA have sent each honoree a gift card in recognition of their achievement. To be selected for a special recognition amongst our laudable faculty and staff is certainly a significant accomplishment. Congratulations to you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. O'Neill. Okay, so can I have a motion to accept the recognition?
DeCaro will
Dunn
move
will
it.
Make a motion.
So DeCaro and
so,
Dunn.
I Dunn, yep. Any questions, comments before we go to a vote? Anybody? Mrs. Cowan.
I just wanted to say congratulations to all of the honorees tonight. And it is so unfortunate that we can't honor you in person. And I look forward to the day that we can. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, I would like to just again echo Ms. Callie. Congratulations. I'm so proud of everyone, especially in this time that we're going through. Everybody has just really stepped up, the teachers, the staff, everyone. And you guys are the best of the best. So congratulations to all the recipients. Thanks.
I'll go. There's not much more to say, but thank you. From the bottom of my heart, thank you. We couldn't do it without you.
Okay, and I do see a number, some of our recipients on, so. Congratulations, you know me, I would be hugging everybody right now, and we can't do that, it's not allowed, so, but, you know, thank you all. So, Mr. Mayor, can we have a roll call, please?
Callie? Bill's on mute.
Yes, sorry.
DeCaro?
Yes, absolutely.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Recognition, resolutions 1 and 2 pass.
Okay, thank you. Before we move on to Mr. Cedadino's report, we actually have one more quick thing, which again, I'm gonna turn it back over to Dr. Hoker.
Thank you, Kelly. And again, I just want to congratulate all the recipients tonight. And I do look forward to when we can all be together to celebrate you in person. I do want to take a minute to talk about one additional person that we would like to honor tonight. This evening, our superintendent, David Cedadino. I want to say a few things here. Under Dave's leadership, he has created a climate and culture where kindness prevails. All decisions are always made based on what is in the best interest of our students. He moves people forward, promoting self-leadership and confidence while advancing programs to be in line with cutting-edge trends to give students the best education. He has made difficult decisions in the face of adversity while always keeping in mind what is best for our students. He continues to promote positivity and provide support to those in need. Personally, he has made me a better leader and more so a better person. I'm extremely grateful for our partnership, and I'm thrilled to announce that our superintendent, David Cedadino, has been recognized with a much deserved honor as the Middlesex County Superintendent of the Year. Congratulations, Dave. I know, I feel like we have to hear a clap.
A virtual clap is okay.
We do have something. Kelly, I'm gonna turn it back to you for just a minute.
Very nervous.
Hang on, I was muted. Okay, here we go. Can you all see you see something I'm sharing?
Yes.
All right, there we go.
Turn the volume up if you can.
It's up.
Yeah, the volume.
You got a friend in me. When you go rough ahead in your miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your past said, or you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything but what you do for you. We stick together to see it through, cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love.
So congratulations, Mr. Cedadino.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And I'm lost for words. I didn't know this was going to be announced tonight. And the only thing disappointing me is that, you know, I would rather not have it on a night when we're recognizing the teachers and the ESPs. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Oh. But on that note, back to you for your superintendent's report.
Well, I want to again thank you everyone for, again, supporting our great educators in Old Bridge, and how adverse things become so quickly, and our educators and our staff always steps up to it and does the best they can in very hard situations. And the only thing I really want to bring to light tonight, and Dr. Hoker, were we going to talk about the schools of the year? Or is that just a ruse to get me to pass it to you earlier.
No, we really were. I think tonight is about our educators, but they're part of this process and what has helped us to become a district of character. So I think this is a good news night, so we should keep it going. So I will share that the district was recertified as a National District of Character for 2020, and we will again hold that title for 5 years, along with 6 of our schools, Old Bridge High School, Carpenter, Memorial, Miller, Shirah, and Southwood Elementary Schools have all been recertified as National Schools of Character. So congratulations, and it's just another testament to our team and the values that we put in place. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hoker, and thank you to the entire board. And again, thank you to our entire Old Bridge community that makes these type of recognitions possible. And none of the accolades that we receive, whether it be District of Character, National District of Character, National Schools of Character, and your personal recognition, or even my recognition tonight, would be possible without everyone from, you know, our transportation department, maintenance department, educators, paras, food service workers, everyone in this district and our leadership. It's not possible without a team effort. I've always said, what's my favorite thing to say? There's the largest room in any organization is the room for improvement, and we keep on improving all the time, and we do it together. So thank you very much, everyone, and let's have a great meeting. The only thing I do want to add is a survey went out tonight. We have plans in place for staff and parents to retrieve student items that are in our school still because of the executive order that our schools are closed until June 30th. We need to get the stuff out of there so we can begin the process of getting our schools ready for the 2020-21 year. So the survey went out. We're just looking at you to fill out a survey for each student. And just to be clear, when we say pick up the items at the school, that does not mean you're going to be in the schools or going through the schools. The items will be presented to you, or you'll be picking up at a designated spot at the school. One person will go in. It will not be a student going in with you. One adult will go in. We have the executive orders that doesn't allow 10 or more people in any building, regardless of the size, and that includes the staff that's already in there. So if we have a custodial person and an administrator in there, that means we only have room for 8 people picking up at that one time. So that's where we're at, and understand that when we do move forward with this, that again, it will just be one person doing the pickup in an orderly manner to keep everyone safe. So thank you very much. Thank you, Old Bridge. You've done a great job over the past few years.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Cedadino. So now we do have our first public meeting, the hearing of residents on any agenda items. If there is anybody who would like to make a comment about any of the agenda items, I would ask you to please go in the chat, put it in the chat, and we will read them off. If you do have a comment, if you want to just raise your hand so we can see that you have a comment, and we'll wait a second so we can see the comment. And actually, I have to stop sharing so I can see the comment. Oh, here we go. No, here they are. Apologies. So if you're gonna have, if there's a comment, just raise your hand. I'm just checking. Okay. All right, I don't see any comments. So we'll continue on. I'll close the public meeting, hearing of residents. We will move on to policies. This is a first reading for some of the policies. I don't know, Mr. Parton, did you wanna just explain this?
I did. We briefly talked about this last week, and there's not a lot to say about policy update 219. Many of these policies are already at or ahead of the mandates in Old Bridge, which is great for you. Some of these policies that are recommended do not need to be adopted because you already have the appropriate procedures in place. A couple of the other ones, such as the updates to law on domestic violence, administration of medication, postnatal accommodations are state mandates and have to be adopted. So, and policy 8220 lastly requires the acknowledgement of 180 days of school, which is maybe ironic timing, but it is also mandated. So unless there are any questions, this is just the first reading. Everybody can take a look through this between now and June, but these are all mandated policies and there's not too much elaborate information in them.
Okay. And for the public, the policies, they're all out on the board page on our website if you want to review them. All right, thank you, Mr. Parton. We will move on to curriculum professional development items 1 through 9. If I could have a motion, please.
Burns will motion.
Lent will second.
Thank you, ladies. Any questions, comments? All right, roll call, Mr. Merrick, please.
Prima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
I'm shutting, yes.
Burn.
Shut the mute off.
Burn.
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
Carol?
Yes.
House Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 9 pass.
Thank you. Athletics is 1 and 2. If I could have a motion, please.
Pally.
Dunn will make.
Pally.
Dunn will second.
And Dunn second. Thank you. Any discussion, comments? Okay. All right, can we have a motion, Mr. Mayor, please?
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Alice Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 and 2 passed.
Thank you. Moving on to finance, number 1 through 9. Can I have a motion, please?
Dunn will move finance items 1 through 9, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Dunn. Can I have a second?
Lent will second.
Second.
Oh.
Okay, I got Lent. Lent.
Thank you. Any questions, discussion, comments?
Just a short comment on resolution number 6, the allocation that the district is receiving for under the CAS Act, $696,903. Approximately $65,000 of those funds have to be allocated to non-public districts within the community. Their balance of $630,000 is restricted in its use. To be used for requirements that came up during the pandemic crisis. It's typically just a one-shot deal. This is not recurring money. It's just to fill any gaps that may have been created as a result of extraordinary expenditures that we had to do during this period. Thank you, Mr. Ellis Forster.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Anyone else? All right, roll call, Mr. Mayor, please.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 9 pass.
Thank you. Next, non-certificated personnel other, number 1 and 2. If I could have a motion, please.
Lent will move it.
Thank you, Mrs. Lent.
Callie will second.
Callie will second. Thank you. Any discussion, question, comments? Okay, Mr. Mayor, roll call, please.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Tally?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolution 1 and 2 pass.
Thank you. On to non-certificated personnel operational, number 1. Can I have a motion, please?
DeCaro will move it.
Burns will second.
DeCaro and Burns.
Oh, Burns, sorry.
Yeah.
Got it.
Thank you. Any questions, comments? All right, roll call, Mr. Mayor, please.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Tally?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolution 1 passes.
Non-certificated personnel other, number 1 through 5. And we do have a administrative correction on 5B. And the name on 5B should be Joe Regina. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. And if I could have a motion, please.
Lent will move it.
Burns DeCaro will second.
Lent first and DeCaro. Thank you. Any questions, comments? No? Good. Okay. Roll call, please, Mr. Mayor.
Burns?
Yes.
Tally?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 5 pass.
Thank you. Next on certificated personnel 1 through 15.
Dunn will move certificated personnel items 1 through 15, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Dunn. Can I have a second?
Tally will second.
Thank you, Mrs. Cowie. And there is also an administrative correction on item 7, and that's within schedule D4. Okay. Any questions, comments? No? All right. If nothing, then Mr. Mayor, roll call, please.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Tally?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 15 pass.
Thank you. On to non-certificated personnel transportation, 1 through 4. If I can have a motion, please.
So moved by Dunn.
Thank you, Mr. Dunn. Can I have a second?
Tally will second.
Thank you, Mrs. Tally. Any questions, comments? None? Then we shall go to roll call, please, Mr. Mara.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Tally?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 4 pass.
Okay, thank you. And two, supplies, equipment, and services, number 1 through 6. If I could have a motion, please.
Lent will move it.
Thank you, Ms. Lent. Can I have a second?
Dunn will second.
Dunn second. Thank you, Mr. Dunn. Any questions, comments? All right. Roll call, Mr. Mayor, please.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 6 pass.
Thank you. On to transportation, number 1 through 9. If I can have a motion, please.
Callie will
move. Dunn will second.
Okay, first is Mrs. Callie, Mr. Dunn. Thank you. Any questions, comments? Okay. If we could have a roll call, please, Mr. Mara.
Giordano?
Yes.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
DePrima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 9 pass.
Thank you. Miscellaneous, 1 through 6. If I can have a motion, please.
DeCaro will move it.
Lent will second.
Thank you. Any questions, comments? I guess if people are doing their remote fire drills, we don't need to know that. just a little remote learning humor. All right. And I got Jim Tui to laugh, thank you. Okay, any other questions, none? All right, thank you. Roll call, Mr. Mara.
Lent?
Yes.
Sulikowski?
Yes.
Burns?
Yes.
Callie?
Yes.
DeCaro?
Yes.
Prima?
Yes.
Dunn?
Yes.
Giordano?
No for resolution 1, yes for the rest.
Ellis Foster?
Yes.
Resolutions 1 through 6 pass.
Thank you. Great. There's no board business. So now we will be moving on to hearing of the residents on any school district item. So if anybody has any comments, questions, you can just please put that in the chat. And if you want to just raise a hand so I know, I will wait to see your comment and we'll read them out. So I'll give just a minute in case anybody has any comments. All right. I do not see any comments coming in. So at this time, I will close the hearing of the residents. And we will move on if there is any old business. If anybody has any old business? Any new business?
I'd just like to say again to the teachers, support staff, and of course, Mr. Cittadino, thank you for everything, especially right now. Obviously, we all know that we're going through a tough time and can't wait for things to get back to normal, but through the thick and thin, you guys have come through and made this district as great as it is. Thank you all.
Anyone else from the board?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, I would like to congratulate all the teachers that won the Teacher of the Year. Congratulate Mr. Cedzino for being Superintendent of the Year. And thank you to all the students and parents that have been going through this and doing the best they can, especially the class of 2020. And I would also like to talk about New Jersey senior Alexis Hammer, whose email to the governor went viral about the importance of having their graduation for the class of 2020. And I would like to assure the people of Old Bridge that we're all in this together and things are going to get better. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? So, thank you. To everyone, it doesn't seem like it's a thank you is enough, but, you know, especially our Teachers of the Year, you know, so many of you deserve this so much, and it was your shining opportunity. We didn't get to do the usual celebration, but as we said, hopefully we will do something when we're all together. We thank you all. We know you're all even working that much harder right now, so we so appreciate that. To, again, all the parents out there, thank you for all that you're doing and our students just hanging in there. And I've been seeing the virtual field days this week, so I think that's just a great thing. So thank you to Mr. Danino and the whole staff there for getting that together. To Mr. Cedzino, I know you probably did not want this to happen, the announcement today, but but a well-deserved recognition. If there is nothing else.
I have one thing. Can I just have one thing?
Yes, you may.
Oh, thank you. So what's been really interesting, and I know Dr. Hooker is experiencing it too, and so we made it a practice a few years ago that anyone hired in with the district has to have a final interview with myself and Dr. Hooker. And it wasn't anything for more than just really getting to know the people. When we followed the practice that was before us, the final interviews would take place at an administrative level prior to the superintendent's office. We were walking into new teachers and not really knowing who they were. So I said, we're not that big of a district that we should know everyone that who's working here as new hires. And we don't hire that many people that we can't put time aside to meet our newest teachers. So what's interesting for me now is, having been in the district for a while, and Dr. Hooker, same thing, not only I've already gone through the phase where I was interviewing students who I knew from high school, now I'm interviewing students who I knew from middle school, which is totally interesting that they all have gone through school, graduated college, and are now looking to enter the workforce as teachers. And there are several on the list tonight of teachers we've hired who have gone through our system. And when we interviewed them, they talked about teachers who were their inspiration to get into teaching. Two of those teachers I know was Ms. Langan and Ms. Celentano, two science teachers, are hiring a lot of science teachers this round. And they both answered the same question the same way, two of our candidates, Alex and Sarah, that they remember science and getting a love for science because of making ice cream in science class and the science Olympics that took place there. So congratulations to teachers who have made a difference in shaping the path of others and wanting to go in education. And I want to give a special congratulations to the Marcus family. I see Alan Marcus, one of the dads who and his wife who I've known since Salk School, is one of our attendees tonight. So probably proudly home with the Marcus family watching virtually as Sarah gets accepted as a new member of our team. And thank you to all of our new members of our team. And you're entering at a very interesting time, and it can only go up from here. So that's the best part about it. So we're going to grow together, get better together, and welcome to the team.
All right, great. I just got something from Mr. Carroll. She would like everybody just to do a quick unmute so we can do a big round of applause for all of our Teachers of the Year and everyone. So, there we go, unmute all. There we go.
Congratulations.
Thank you. All right. So that ends the regular portion. We are going into closed session. Mr. Parton?
Yes, you're going into closed session. You need a motion for discussion of food service contracting and personnel.
So could I have a motion, please? Food services and personnel.
So I'll make a motion to go to executive session for personnel and food services.
Okay.
To Carol, a second.
And to Carol, a second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions? So we are going into executive session at 8:17.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you to the public. Have a good evening, and please stay safe and healthy.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Okay, we are no longer on YouTube. And we are no longer recording.
I still see some participants, attendees, one attendee left. Oh, one attendee gone.
Show zero now.
I still see a name.
Yeah, I still see a name. So hang on for a second.
It might be because she made a comment. I'm not sure.
It says zero. Hang on. Let me just. It says zero. So let me just do one other thing. I saved. I don't know why it's there. It says she's not, there it goes. Okay. All right, there we go. Oh, hang on, no. We're also recording. Let me stop recording.